guys, Ralph here, True Power Trumpet Fitness, and welcome to Wonderful Wednesday here in Connecticut. And it is wonderful. I can't take it anymore, guys. I'm going to bundle up and I have to go out for a bike ride. The sun, there's not a cloud in the sky. It's still barely 50, so it's going to be cold. If anybody's ever a biker out there, the bike creates its own wind chill. So it is significantly cooler when you're on the bike than, you know, the regular temperature. But anyway, that's that. I'm out today. I'll let you know how it goes tomorrow. Anyway, I played a little bit. Let's see what we got. You saw the thumbnail. Put the megaphone on the spit buzz. That's all there is to it. You saw the thumbnail. You didn't know my former employer could play the tuba, did you? If all it took was a lot of hot air, he would be the greatest brass player that ever lived. So there, once again, debunks Arnold Jacobs. Anyway, I digress. Anyway, I have a funny story to tell you. And the guy that told me this story is probably watching. He likes to watch the videos. But he, very good trumpet player from Canada, and he is from the UK, okay? So he speaks with a very thick British accent. And it was, lesson was going along, his first lesson, doing quite well. And we're talking about, his chops are very tight, relaxing the tone. He says, "That is so different from anything I've ever played. All the other systems, they have my lips as tight as a duck's ass." And I just broke up laughing. "Whoa, what's so funny?" And I imitated him. I said, "As tight as a duck's ass?" And we had a good chuckle. I must have told 100 people in the last week that story, and they all thought it was hilarious. I guess my spot-on British accent has something to do with it. But anyway, do not let your chops get tight as a duck's ass. And anyway, I'm not laughing at you. You know who you are. I'm laughing with you. We had a great lesson. Anyway, guys. All you do is put the megaphone on. Guys, that's all a trumpet is. It's a megaphone. The sound is going to get all screwed up because I'm too close. Okay? Now, when you are spit buzzing, guys, you have to take special care with the spit buzz. And I've said this a zillion times, and I'm gonna whack you over the head with this, because this is the whole ball of wax. Okay? Guys, you can spit buzz incorrectly. You absolutely can. You have to take special care to make sure the tongue is pressed against that, the soft inner end of the bottom lip, that it's going up when it's flexing. It's on my top teeth. Guys, that's up. Absolutely it. Now, that is why I don't have to warm up. You think about it. When you guys get up in the morning and you had a tough night the night before and you start spit buzzing, okay? Does it? No. That doesn't feel stiff and sore. It's not until you put the mouthpiece on. As long as you can spit buzz behind it and then just place the megaphone, that's all this is. It's a megaphone. Albeit a very expensive one, but it is a megaphone. It does not make sound on its own. The trumpet does not vibrate. The trumpet does not vibrate. The air does not vibrate. The lips vibrate. Now, listen. You do not. Do not. Well, I don't do it, and I'll tell you why. Don't do this. It stands to reason that you should be a spit buzz. And then just place the mouthpiece on while you're spit buzzing. I'm not big about that, and I'll tell you why. Maybe if you're better at it than I am, but your lip, if it's vibrating, vibration means to move. It is literally moving. So you are trying to place that mouthpiece on a moving target. And it doesn't always get in the right spot. You get in awkward situation, positions and all this sort of stuff. Okay? So I don't advocate doing that. That gets to some really weird notes and tones. Now remember, the feel will tell you if it's right, and the tone will tell you if it's right. So if you're in a weird position and it's not a right tone, it's not right. So don't waste time doing that. Okay? You can experiment with that if you want. But again, it's really not going to give you an accurate feel because it's moving. It's trying to hit a moving target. Okay? Now, guys, spit buzz, spit buzz, spit buzz. Make sure you are spit buzzing correctly. Make sure you have a proper mouthpiece. Okay? And make sure that tongue is pressed against the soft inner red. It will feel like it is pressing against the side molars. Okay, that tongue barely moved. It was so packed in, it barely moved. That's an octave. I don't have perfect pitch. I don't know what that is. B flat. That's why I don't have to use pressure. That's why I don't have to warm up. It's all done right there at that point of attack. And you're back. Okay? You can change mouthpieces. You can change trumpets. From the E trumpet, from the B flat to the E flat, back to the E flat. That's how you're doing it. Okay? Sounds good. Okay, guys, have a great day. Eat and drink your fruits and vegetables, and I'm going out for a bike ride. Enjoy your day. Love you all. 1, 2, 3.